Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about the multiple choice question and answer from the first unit of antenna and microwave engineering. So already we discussed the three videos about the antenna basics and antenna parameters. So this is the fourth video. So if you want to learn that previous three video means, I will give the link for those videos in the description box and icon. You can refer it. Okay. So here we will see the questions. The first one, if the radiation resistance is low, the antenna efficiency is dash. So do you know the relation between the radiation resistance and antenna efficiency? Yes, already we studied the relation between the antenna efficiency and the radiation resistance. So the efficiency eta equal to radiation resistance RR divided by RR plus RL. Okay, so in this formula, the question is that if the radiation resistance value, this RR value, okay, so this two RR value decreases means what is the antenna efficiency? So it is a high, low, unchanged. So it's a low only. Then the next question, find the efficiency if the radiation resistance of the antenna is 72 ohms and the loss resistance is 8 ohms. Okay, so using the above formula, so here there is a problem, it's a 2-mark problem. So here the question is that we have to find the efficiency of the antenna given that the radiation resistance 72 ohms and the loss resistance is 8 ohms. So you just substitute the radiation resistance value and the loss resistance value in an efficiency formula, we will get the answer. Okay, so you see the efficiency eta equal to RR divided by RR plus RL. So what is the value of RR? 72 divided by it's addition of the radiation resistance 72 plus the last resistance 8. So 72 divided by 80. So the answer is 0.9. Okay, so the C is the answer. Then the next question, find the directivity if the radiation resistance of antenna is 72 ohms. That is the same data. Radiation resistance is 72 ohm. Last resistance is 8 ohm. And the power gain is given as 15. Okay, so the three data is given. Here the question is that we have to find the directivity. Okay, so first one, in order to calculate the directivity, so using this radiation resistance and the loss resistance, so first we have to determine the efficiency. Okay, since we are having the relation between the radiation resistance, loss resistance and efficiency. So the efficiency equal to RR divided by RR plus RL. So the answer is 0.9. Okay, then now you know the power gain value, efficiency value. So using this power gain and efficiency, we have to calculate the directivity. So what is the relation between the efficiency, power gain and directivity? So the efficiency is equal to power gain divided by directivity. So from this, the directivity D, it can be written as the power gain divided by eta. So 15 divided by the efficiency value is 0.9. So the answer is 16.67. So the 16.67 is the answer. Okay, so this is a one type of question. Then the next one, a dipole antenna has a radiation resistance of 72 ohms and a loss resistance of 18 ohms. Find its efficiency. Okay, so the same one, using the radiation resistance and the loss resistance, we have to determine the efficiency of one dipole antenna. So the same formula only. So here that is the answer is in terms of percentages given. So after calculating the efficiency, you just multiply with 100. It is the conversion for the percentage. So eta equal to 72 divided by 72 plus 18. So the answer is 0.8. Okay. So this is the efficiency in number. If we want to find the efficiency in terms of percentage means you just multiply it with 100. So the answer is 80%. Okay. So the efficiency of this dipole antenna, it's a 80%. Then the next question, the loss resistance of antenna is 24 ohms. Calculate its radiation resistance. Okay. So in the previous four problem, radiation resistance value, loss resistance is given. We may calculate the efficiency, directivity and so on. But here, the loss resistance of the antenna or L is given. The question is that we have to find the radiation resistance. Okay. Under the condition, if the power gain is 28 and the directivity is 40. So here, the power gain, directivity and loss resistance is given. So using these three data, we have to determine the radiation resistance. Okay, so there is same relation only. The first one, so already you know the two relation for the efficiency. That is one relation is that the efficiency is nothing but the power gain divided by D. Okay, so here this power gain is given, D value is also given. Okay, so using this ratio, we may calculate the efficiency. And one more relation for the efficiency is that the efficiency eta equal to RR divided by RR plus RL. Okay, so in this case, the last resistance, this RL is given. So our question is to, we have to find this value RR. Okay, so that's why you just substitute the value. So GP, the power gain is 28, directivity is 40. So 28 divided by 40 equal to RR divided by RR plus 24. So you just cross multiply and you rearrange the term. So after simplifying, we will get the radiation resistance value. It's a 56 ohm. Okay, so the answer is, the 56 ohm is the answer. Okay, using the same relation. So here the given data is different. So the question is different. Okay, so using this, we may calculate the radiation resistance. Okay, so these are all the important two mark problems. Then the next question, when the side loop level increases, the bandwidth also increases in general. Okay, so you know, in a radiation pattern, okay, so in a radiation pattern, the side loop level, you know, this is the main loop, this is the side loop. When the side loop level increases, the beam width also increases. Okay, it's a yes or no, it's a no. Okay, if side loop level increases, the bandwidth is not at all increases. Okay, then the next question, the expression for the quality factor in terms of the resonant frequency and bandwidth is given by. So what is the quality factor of our antenna in terms of resonant frequency and bandwidth? So already you familiar with the quality factor expression in terms of resonant frequency and bandwidth. So already we studied this relation in circuit analysis, EC2 and etc. Okay, so what is the relation between the quality factor, resonant frequency and bandwidth? The quality factor Q, it is nothing but it's a ratio of resonant frequency divided by the bandwidth. Okay, so the answer is the B is the correct answer. It's the quality factor, it's nothing but the resonant frequency divided by the bandwidth. Okay, then the next one. So using this above formula, so there is a one problem. Find the Q of an antenna. Okay, find the quality factor of an antenna if the resonant frequency is 15 megahertz and having a bandwidth of 4 megahertz. So here the resonant frequency and bandwidth is given. The question is that we have to determine the quality factor. So you know the relation between the quality factor, resonant frequency and bandwidth. So the quality factor, it is equal to ratio of resonant frequency by bandwidth. So here both resonant frequency and bandwidth is in the megahertz. Okay, 15 megahertz divided by 4 megahertz. So 15 mega divided by 4 mega. So mega cancel. So the answer is 3.75. Okay, so and you know the quality factor, for quality factor, there is no unit. It's a dimensionless quantity. So 3.75 is the answer. Okay, then the next question, the receiving antenna in radio receivers normally are dash. Okay, there are several types of antenna is that. Okay, dipole antenna, loop antenna, in loop antenna, various types of loop antenna, rhombic, log periodic antenna, horn antenna, then a microstrip antenna. There are so many varieties of antenna is there. So which antenna is used in a radio receiver for receiving purpose, means it is the ferrite rod and loop antenna. Okay, then the next question, what is the power radiated by an antenna with gain? Okay, what is the power radiated by the antenna with gain? That is the multiplication of power radiated with the gain of the antenna is called as critical power, transfer power, effective radiated power, transmitted power, effective radiated power. Okay, ERP. So the effective radiated power, it is nothing but it's a product of, okay, so the effective radiated power is nothing but it's a product of the transmitter power and the power gain of the antenna. Okay, the product of transmitter power feed to the antenna and the power gain of that particular antenna, it is called as the effective radiated power. Okay, then the next one, considering distance as a parameter, two types of field zones can be defined around an antenna. It's a true or false? True. Okay. So considering a distance as a parameter, three types of field zone is there around the antenna. So already you know. So in that, considering the distance as a parameter, two types of field zone is there. It's a true only. Okay. So what are the two that a field zone means? The first one is near field or Fresnel region. The other one is a far field. It's a Fraunhofer region. Okay. So near field, the field nearer to the antenna, it is called as a near field region or Fresnel region. Then the far field, it is otherwise called as a Fraunhofer region. So these are all the two region available in the field zone if the distance is a parameter. Then the next question, at what distance from the antenna does the far field start? Okay, the far field, it starts at what distance? 2 lambda, that is 2 wavelength. 2 lambda, 5 wavelength, 10 wavelength, 25 wavelength. Okay, 10 wavelength. After 10 wavelength only, we are considering that distance as a far field. Okay, the far field region, it starts at a distance of 10 wavelength of the particular antenna. Okay, depending upon the operating frequency, this wavelength value, it will vary. Then the next question, the far field is also known as dash. Fresnel zone, Fraunhofer zone, Maxwell zone, and Marconi zone. So the far field, it is otherwise called as Fraunhofer zone. The near field is called as Fresnel. Okay, the far field is called as a Fraunhofer zone. Okay, then the next question, which antenna radiating region have or has independent nature of angular field distribution over the distance from the antenna? Reactive near field region, Fresnel region, Fraunhofer region, all of the above. Okay, Fraunhofer region, the far field region, it is otherwise called as Fraunhofer region. The next one, the field in the Fresnel zone are radio waves that contain information transmitted. It's a true or false? The Fresnel zone means, you know, the near field region, it is called as a Fresnel region. So in this Fresnel region, the fields in the Fresnel zone are radio waves that contain the information transmitted. It's a true or false? It's a false. Okay. Why means the near field describe the region directly around the antenna. Okay. So where the electric and the magnetic fields are distinct. So these fields are not the radio waves. Okay. So after the Fresnel zone, we will get the information. Okay. We will get the radio waves that contain the information to be transmitted. Then the next one, a parabolic reflector used for the reception with direct broadcast system is 16 inches in diameter and operates at 12.4 gigahertz. So the two data is given. One is the parabolic reflector with the diameter of the parabolic reflector is 18 inches. And the operating frequency is 12.4 gigahertz. So the far field distance for this antenna, it is given by. So, you know, the far field distance, the relation, okay, far field distance, it is calculated by the formula is that 2d squared divided by lambda. Okay, where lambda is the operating wavelength, d is the diameter of the particular antenna. So here the D is given, it's a 18 inches, okay, divided by the operating frequency is given 12.4 gigahertz. So first you convert that frequency, okay, F into lambda. So the lambda value equal to, lambda is equal to C divided by F. Okay, C is nothing but 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by the frequency is 12.4 giga. Giga means into 10 to the power 9. Okay, so you calculate lambda. Then you substitute D value and a lambda value in this formula. We will get the answer is 17.3 meter. Okay, so 17.3 meter. So this is the far field distance for that particular parabolic reflector. Okay, then the next one, balloon means dash. Okay, in antenna, the balloon, what is mean by balloon means it's a balanced to unbalanced transformer. The BAL, the first BAL, it is indicating balanced. Then UN, it is an unbalanced. So So the balanced to unbalanced transformer, it is shortly denoted as balloon in the antenna parameter. Okay, so the next one, when an electromagnetic wave travels from transmitter to receiver, which factor or factors affects the propagation level? Okay, so when we are that is transmitting the electromagnetic wave from transmitter to receiver, what are all the factors that affect the propagation level? One is curvature of earth, another one is roughness of earth, magnetic field of earth, all of the above. So all of the above, all these factors, it will affect the propagation level. The next question, low is the G by T ratio, higher its efficiency. What is G by T? G means gain of the antenna. T is the temperature, antenna temperature. So the ratio gain to the antenna temperature ratio, if is low, means the efficiency is high. This statement is true or false? It's a false. Okay. The G by T ratio, where G is the gain of the antenna, T is the antenna noise temperature. Okay. Higher the G by T ratio, the antenna is the better performance. Okay. If the G by T ratio is high, means at the time only the efficiency is high. If the G by T value, gain value is low, means the efficiency is also low only. Okay. So it is the false. This statement is false. Then next question, basic transmission loss between the two antennas depends on. Okay, so the transmission loss, that is, this is the transmitting antenna, this is receiving antenna, means, so you know, when we are transmitting signal from one place to another place, there may be a loss is available, transmission loss is available. So the basic transmission loss between the two antenna, it depends on frequency, distance between the two antenna, or frequency and distance, gain of the antenna. So which one is correct? Means frequency and distance. Based on the frequency, operating frequency, based on the distance between the two antenna, the basic transmission loss, it will vary. Okay. Then the next one, actual transmission loss between the two antenna depends on frequency, distance, gain of antenna, all of the above. So the frequency, distance, gain of the antenna, all of the above is the answer. Okay. So this is the basic, okay, basic transmission loss occurs due to frequency and distance, but actual transmission loss between the two antenna depends on the three factors, frequency, distance, gain of the antenna. The next question, the antenna temperature is the temperature of the antenna. This statement is correct or not? Antenna temperature, you know, we are using the term antenna temperature. That antenna temperature is the temperature of the antenna? No, okay. The antenna temperature, it is not a physical temperature of the antenna. So it is depends upon the noise factor and the signal level. We will get some temperature. It is called as the antenna temperature. Okay. Then the next one, the relation between the effective noise temperature and the noise figure is dash. Okay. So the relation between effective noise temperature and the noise figure, it is nothing but the effective noise temperature TE equal to T naught into Fn minus 1, where Fn is the noise figure. T naught is said to be the that is temperature. Okay, noise equivalent of temperature. So this is the effective noise temperature of the particular antenna. T equal to T naught into Fn minus 1. Then the next question, equivalent noise temperature of transmission line connecting the antenna to the receiver is dash. Okay. So if we are, that is, one antenna is connected with one transmission line, means what is the equivalent noise temperature of the transmission line? Okay. So the relation is TP into LT minus 1. Okay. This is the noise equivalent of temperature. So TP into LT minus 1, where TP is the physical temperature of the antenna. LT is the loss. Okay. If you are connecting one transmission line to some antenna, you know, or receiver section or transmitter section, that loss is said to be LT. So the noise equivalent of temperature is TP into LT minus 1. So the A is the answer. Then the next one, the antenna temperature considers dash parameter into account. So while calculating the antenna temperature, So what are all the parameter we are taking into account? Directivity, gain, beam area, beam efficiency, gain. Okay, the antenna temperature considers the gain parameter into account. The next one, with an increase in operating frequency, the background noise temperature increases, decreases, remains constant, remains unchanged. The increasing operating frequency, the background noise is also increases. Okay, so the background noise, it increases with the increase in the frequency region. Okay, then the next one, the noise temperature of the antenna is given by the expression. Okay, so this is the expression for noise temperature of the particular antenna. So the antenna temperature, the antenna noise temperature, TA is equal to eta radiation, that is radiation efficiency into TB plus 1 minus radiation efficiency into TB, where TB is the brightness temperature. Okay, so this is the noise temperature of the antenna. So you have to remember these relations. Okay, so which one is the correct? A is the correct answer. The noise temperature, the antenna temperature, it is given by TA equal to eta radiation into, where eta radiation is the efficiency. TB is the brightness temperature. Eta radiation into TB plus 1 minus eta into TB. Then the next one, one of the most important requirement of radio receiver is high gain. Okay, yes. While we are designing the radio receiver, the gain is a very important requirement. Okay. So why in radio receiver, the gain is a very important requirement? When we are receiving the signal, that signal, it is having the very low power level. Okay. So in order to detect that very low power signal, that radio receiver must have the high gain. Okay. So that's why the statement is correct. Radio receiver, while designing radio receiver, the gain, high gain is an important parameter. Okay. Then the next question, a radio receiver operating at microwave frequency must have a very high selectivity. It's a true or false. Okay. So in while designing the receiver, the selectivity, gain, bandwidth, these are all the measurement parameters. Okay. So in order to design one radio receiver at a microwave frequency, the selectivity, it's a very important parameter. Okay. Since in our, that is a channel, in our channel, there are so many frequency signals are available. So in order to receive our particular desired signal, the selectivity of the receiver must be high. Okay. So the selectivity must be high only. Then the next one, Ferris transmission formula is, okay, the Ferris transmission formula. So there are two Ferris transmission formula is there. One is the received power in terms of transmitted power. That is a effective aperture area of transmitting antenna, receiving antenna, wavelength and distance. This is one formula. Another one is the received power in terms of transmitter power, gain of the transmitting antenna, gain of the receiving antenna, wavelength and the distance between the two antenna. So these two formulas are a Ferris formula. So the first one, the received power, PR is equal to PT. PT means transmitted power into AET. AET means effective aperture of transmitting antenna into AER, effective aperture of receiving antenna, divided by lambda squared, wavelength squared into R. R is the distance between transmitting and receiving antenna. So this is the one relation. Similarly, if you are substituting the AET and AER value, we will get one more relation in terms of gain of the transmitting antenna and gain of the receiving antenna. So the same received power is equal to PT into GT, GR, lambda divided by 4 pi R the whole squared. So these are all the very important equations, the Ferris transmission formula for a radio link. The next one, the amount of power by which the received power must be greater than the threshold level required to maintain a minimum quality of service is called dash. Okay. Line loss, link budget, link margin, none of them above, link margin. Okay. The amount of power by which the received power must be greater than the threshold value required, it is called as the link margin. Then the link margin that is used to account for fading effect is called as fade margin. So true or false? True. Okay. Link margin used to account for fading effect. It is called as a fade margin. Then the next question, if a distance between the transmitting station and the receiving station is 1 kilometer, if the antenna operating at a wavelength of 5 centimeter, then the path losses. Okay, so the transmitting antenna, receiving antenna is separated by the distance of 1 kilometer, and it is operating at a wavelength lambda equal to 5 centimeter. Means what is the path loss? Okay, so already you know the path loss, it varies with respect to distance. Okay, so the path loss formula is that the path loss in dB equal to 20 log of 4 pi r by lambda. So here r is the distance, lambda is the wavelength. So you just substitute and find out the answer. We will get the answer is a 108 dB. Then the next question, a radio link has 15 watts transmitter connected to an antenna of 2.5 meter squared effective aperture at 5 gigahertz. The receiving antenna has effective aperture of 0.5 meter squared and located at a 15 kilometer line of sight from the transmitting antenna. Assuming lossless matched antenna, the power delivered to the receiver is dash. Okay, so here what are the data given? This 15 watts, it is nothing but a transmitter power, PT. This 2.5 meter squared, this is the effective aperture of transmitting antenna. This 0.5 squared, it is the effective aperture of receiving antenna. 15 kilometer, this is the distance between transmitting antenna and receiving antenna. Okay, and the next one, this 5 gigahertz, it's the operating frequency. So using this data, the question is that what is the power delivered to the receiver? That is power received by the receiver, we have to calculate. So using the Ferri's formula, the power received is equal to PT AET AER divided by lambda squared into R squared. So in that, first we have to calculate the wavelength. So what is the wavelength? The wavelength is nothing but C divided by F. Okay. So what is the value of C? 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by the frequency F, here given as 5 gigahertz. So 5 into 10 to the power 9. So the wavelength is 0.06. Okay. Then you substitute this wavelength, this effective aperture of transmitting antenna, receiving antenna, transmitter power in the formula, we will get the answer as a 23 microwatt. Okay. So here you see the PT is 15, AET 0.5, AER 2.5 divided by the 0.06 squared into R, the distance is 15 kilometers. So 15 into 10 to the power 3, the whole square. So we will get the answer is a 23 micro watts. Okay, so this is the watts. This is not a meter. 23 micro watts is the answer. Okay, then the next question. Linear polarization can be obtained only if the wave consists of dash. EX, EY, both EX and EY and in phase, both EX and EY are out of phase. So both EX and EY is in phase. In phase means that polarization wave, it is called as a linear polarized waves. Okay, then the next question, which of the following is not true? The first one, the right circular polarized antenna can pick up left circular polarized wave due to the propagation effect. The circular polarization has less attenuation in free space. Circular polarized wave can follow the curvature of Earth. In circular polarization, the electric and magnetic field rotate as they leave antenna. So out of this four statement, which one is not true? Okay, so the C is the not true. The circular polarized wave can follow the curvature of Earth. It is the truth statement. This is not a truth one. Okay, so these are all the some of the questions about this antenna parameter part 4. Okay, so thanks for watching my video and keep watching my, in the next video, we will discuss about the second unit. Okay, the different types of antennas and applications we will see in the next video. If you want to learn the remaining three videos, means I will give the link in the description box, you can refer it. Okay, so thank you.